A woman who has taken a shortcut through some woods in Jefferson County stumbles upon a badly decomposed human remains there. The sheriff's office says the bones found off of Sugar Creek Road near Highway 30 had been there for at least a few weeks. Fox News' Aisha Khan is live in High Ridge with more on what people who live nearby are saying.
Hey there, John. Well, the wooded area that this woman was cutting through is actually adjacent to the BP gas station that is behind me. And it's actually in a pretty busy area. Now, some people who live nearby tell me that they remember smelling something so awful. So it was a very strong stench in this particular area every time they drove past. And it's a smell that they said they'll never forget. Cindy Day says she can still distinctly remember from 3 weeks ago a very pungent odor coming from the woods just off of Sugar Creek Road near Highway 30.
And we thought a dead animal. And like if you were standing right here, you wouldn't smell it. But go up by the road and go up to the next house and you could smell it.
Jefferson County deputies say a woman taking a shortcut through that same wooded area behind a BP gas station stumbled on human remains late Monday afternoon. They say the bones are so badly decomposed, even an autopsy couldn't reveal whether it's a man or a woman. They say the remains have been there for at least a few weeks.
But now I feel bad that we didn't go walking through the woods to see what it was.
Cindy's nephew, who lives next door, also remembers that same stench permeating the air.
You know, I never thought anything of it. The only thing that was peculiar was the amount of time that we smelled it.
Their neighbors say people, mostly young adults or kids, are often seen walking back and forth through the woods behind the gas station.
Over here, this is like 10 acres of woods. And anybody can come out here and dump something if they want to.
Now everyone is just waiting for answers.
It's real unnerving. It's like, damn, I thought we were safe out here.
Now, the sheriff's office tells me that the examiner continues to take a closer look at the bones to figure out what may have happened and to whom they belong to. Reporting live in High Ridge tonight, Aisha Khan, Fox 2 News.